Now, the pandemic is putting a unique strain on special education programs. Alexa Liacco found how it's taking a toll on students and their families.
Okay, so I have a guessing game. It's Disney themed.
They just told us it's a temporary thing.
It's been 5 months.
Josephine, who do you think?
5 months of a home turned special needs classroom for 11-year-old Josephine Senek.
She's got multiple disabilities, including a rare chromosome disorder. She's missing the connective tissue in her brain, and then she's got autism.
The Seneks, like families across the country, were forced into remote learning because of COVID-19.
That's good.
But for a child with disabilities, it's an entirely different experience.
It's different because we're mom and dad. We're not therapist, we're not teacher, we're not aide.
But Krista and her husband were thrust into all those roles.
Emotionally, we were absolutely wrecked. She would melt down and hit us, pull our hair, scratch us.
Thankfully for the Senecks, their teenage son Sheldon is stepping in to be Josephine's aide.
We take virtual field trips to Europe, Africa.
But Sheldon's help is just for the summer, and it's not what Josephine is used to. In school, she had professionally trained aides with her every day.
It just blew her up, and she couldn't focus, she couldn't learn, she couldn't get therapy.
For students with special needs, the therapy they get in school is critical to developing social skills and maintaining physical health.
I just don't want her to go backwards. When a child with disabilities goes backwards, it takes us twice as long to get back to where we need to be.
Krista says the last few months have impacted her own health too.
Our school district and the school, they all thought about what's best for the kids. Nobody thought about the parents.
It's been the toughest time in her life as a mother.
I don't blame my daughter, but it is a result of caring for a child with special needs that I have PTSD.
The emotional weight made worse, worrying for her daughter's future.
I have no idea what her future is going to hold for her. Okay? I'm nervous that maybe she would have been in a group home, independent. Now she might need a nursing home.
Senek is hopeful this fall her daughter can safely return to school. But she says for all families with special needs students, the time to ask for help is now.
Moving forward, we need the proper assistance, regardless of where we are with this pandemic. The special needs population cannot be forgotten.
I'm Alexa Liacco.